Hello YouTube, and so today I want to share with you the front-run smart contract bot that I recently developed that can help you make large amounts of profit within a short amount of time. So the following are the steps on how the UniSwap smart contract bot works. First, the bot connects to the blockchain network, then it scans for pending transactions, or mempool. After the bot finds pending transactions, it matches liquidity and adds the token you have selected. The bot then places the buy order in the same block, which pumps the market slightly. The bot then waits for the identified transaction to come through, which executes at a higher price and pumps the market even more. The bot then places the sell order and makes easy profits. To start off, make sure you have MetaMask installed and connected to the Ethereum mainnet. That's about halfway there. Go to the sidebar on the left and create a new contract under Contracts folder. We're going to name it Bot. Next, copy the code from here and paste it into our bot.sol file, the one that we just created. So a thing to look at here at the line 50 is this address. If you follow this address on Etherscan, you will see that it's the address of the wrapped Ethereum token. So we're going to be competing with it. Now that we have our bot.sol file ready, let's compile it. So to do that, we go over to the Solidity Compiler tab. On the left, there's a column of symbols. Click on the second one and change the compiler version to 0.6.6 plus commit plus 6 C089D02 in the first selected field. Click on the Compile bot.sol button and wait for the file to compile. Alright, so now we're getting ready to deploy this to our wallet. So go on over to Deploy and Run Transactions in Remix, select Injected Web 3 as the environment, and then MetaMask will ask you for confirmation to connect your wallet to Remix. Click on the Next and Connect buttons in the MetaMask pop-up window. Then click on the Deploy button and confirm the signature in MetaMask. Okay, so opening up the wallet, let's check these out. And 146, perfect, confirm. All right, looking good. All right, so the transaction is confirmed. And now we can see the deployed contracts just below the deploy button. So now we need to make sure that our contract shows up in Etherscan. So copy the address by clicking on the button next to the generated contract address and head on over to Etherscan. Great, so the contract is created. The next step in this process is just funding our contract. Let's go to the wallet and send some funds to the contract that we just created. I'm going to start with 1 Ether. After it's sent to the contract and pressing the action button, the bot automatically starts buying and selling for you. Give it some time to generate profit. And look, I mean, I usually leave it for about 24 hours, and then I withdraw the profit. Alright, so the transaction is confirmed, and our contract is funded. Yep, the contract now has 1 Ether in its balance. To activate the contract, just press the action button and confirm the transaction. Let's wait and check the profit for the full 24 hours of the bot's runtime. Just click here and let's open up the wallet. All right, this looks good, and confirm. Let's see, what do we have here? So I made around 0.3 Ethereum of profit. Now I am going to withdraw the funds from my contract. To do that, just press the action button and confirm the transaction. Okay, so I'm opening up the wallet and confirming the transaction. Perfect. And now we just wait. Yep, I've got my balance plus the profit the bot made for me. If you have any difficulties setting up the bot for your wallet, feel free to ask me in Telegram. And do let me know if you have any questions down below in the comments section. Oh, and don't forget to follow so that you'll stay updated.
Hi, today we're going to talk about front running. What is front running? Front running has a narrow legal definition on Wall Street. We'll use the term more broadly. We'll say that front running is a type of misbehavior that hurts users of traditional financial markets and cryptocurrencies. It's when someone can respond to privileged and valuable market influencing information before others have a chance. In this video, we explain how it works for cryptocurrencies and why it's harmful. In the stock market, for example, brokers learn their clients' trades. A corrupt broker might use this knowledge to make their own trades first, profiting off their clients. Or high-frequency traders will compete with each other to get in front of each other's transactions via special fiber optic wires or radio networks. In the cryptocurrency world, there are even more different ways one can front run, as we'll shortly discuss. Let's consider an example. A decentralized exchange, or DEX, is a system that allows users to trade cryptocurrencies with one another. It runs on top of a blockchain in a blockchain application called a smart contract. Say Alice wants to sell some token on a DEX, say widget tokens, ticker WAT. She publishes to the world an offer to sell 10 widgets for 1 Ether. Now, this is a very low price, and Bob immediately decides he wants to take the order and buy 10 widgets. To do this, he broadcasts his own matching counter order in the blockchain system, sending the counter order to the exchange smart contract. But there's a problem. Our monocled and mustached frontrunner also wants to take Alice's juicy offer. He steps in and broadcasts his own counter order. It turns out that in most blockchain systems, if the frontrunner is clever, he can get his order to the contract before Bob's goes through, even if Bob submitted his order first. In fact, the frontrunner benefits from seeing Bob's order first. To many people, this might seem unfair. After all, Bob tried to take the order first. Let's see how it happens. Recall that cryptocurrency proof-of-work-based systems, such as Bitcoin or Ethereum, work by having a copy of the same distributed ledger, chain of blocks, on each computer. Before a transaction is mined, though, it somehow has to be sent to all the miners so they can attempt to include it in a block. Now, the way this happens is that when someone wants to perform a new transaction, she tells all of the computers she is connected to about her transaction, and those computers forward that transaction to all of the computers they are connected to. This process is known as broadcasting a transaction. Transactions that have been broadcast but not yet mined in a block are kept on each computer in a storage space called the mempool. Everybody on the network keeps their own mempool of transactions they've seen, but that have not yet been confirmed in blocks. A frontrunner can exploit the fact that transactions are broadcast to mempools around the network. By listening to transaction broadcasts, a frontrunner can see new transactions before they're mined. This gives an opportunity for a frontrunner to get a transaction placed in a block before the transaction of a victim. How does a frontrunner get their transaction placed first in a block? They include a higher fee in their transaction than the one in the victim's transaction. Miners usually process higher fee transactions first to maximize their profit. So the frontrunner can essentially bribe miners to give their transactions priority. Now, some people might say that this is fine. A fair and efficient market should prioritize the fastest person with the highest transaction fees. So, this is just the market working as intended. But frontrunners can exploit this feature to harm users, effectively cutting ahead of users in line in applications, a few of which we'll discuss now. See the description below for a more thorough list. The example we've already given, in which a frontrunner cuts ahead of Bob while he tries to trade with Alice, is the first case. Frontrunners can actually get quite aggressive and will often try to frontrun other frontrunners. If one frontrunner tries to take Alice's juicy transaction, another frontrunning might try to squeeze ahead and take Alice's transaction first. In a recent research publication entitled Flash Boys 2.0, we've shown how frontrunners make millions of dollars a year and how they compete with one another to rake in this money. We explain how frontrunners in blockchain systems look a lot like some of the aggressive traders on Wall Street. The link is in the description below. Another commonly discussed application of smart contracts is domain name registration, such as the Ethereum name service. This service allows users to register their own Ethereum domain names that replace long numerical addresses. Sunglasses Man might, for example, try to register the name coolestsunglasses.eth so that his friends have an easy-to-remember address to send money to him. If a frontrunner sees him doing this, though, the frontrunner can get the domain name first and then turn around and try to sell it to Sunglasses Man at an inflated price. The Ethereum name service specifically designed their registration process to mitigate this problem, and so they're not vulnerable in real life because they went to the trouble to design around the issue. Initial coin offerings are yet a